Hello guys, this is Mike from McProgramming.org. I decided to start making videos on different sorting algorithms, and I'll start with the easiest to understand so we can build our way up. And these are a great introduction to sorting, but they are not very beneficial as far as efficiency goes or how long it takes for them to work. So we will end up getting in more involved ones. I have up here in the comments, this is going to be the array we're going to be messing with, and I'll code it out real quick, and then I'll come back here and explain what I and J are doing and what this temp value is doing. So if you read this in a book or you hear a professor talking about it, they use a lot of letters to represent variables and abstract, you know, thinking, and a lot of people have a hard time getting that. So I'm going to try to make this a little bit easier for y'all to understand. So let me code this up for you real quick. I am going to make the sort its own method. I have created a really small array just called numbers and made sure they're out of order. So I'm going to say public, and I have to call it static because I don't feel like creating an instance of bubble sort. So let's say public static, and we will return an int. Let's just call it bubble sort. That makes sense. Bubble sort, and we need to pass it integer array. And the common notation is a capital A when you're looking at algorithm books or something like that. So I'm going to try to stick with that, but explain it better than you can read it out of a book. So we're going to end up needing a return statement at the end. So now we can call bubble sort from the main method and pass in numbers that would be considered this A right here. So what we're going to do is we're going to have a nested for loop, okay? Because we're going to have a variable I for the outer loop and a variable J for the inner loop. Let's code that out real quick. For int I equals 0. And then we're going to say while I is less than numbers.length minus 1. And increment I every iteration of the loop. And whoops, didn't mean to write numbers, I meant to write A. So in case you have other arrays, you can pass in whatever array, and A just is the array that has been passed in through the parameter. So let's do J now for int J equals 0. So let's start at 0, and it's going to run while it's less than A.length minus 1. Minus I, okay? That looks strange, but I'll explain it in just a minute. We're going to increment J every time. And inside of this inner loop, we are going to have to make a comparison, okay? So we're going to say if A index J, if that is greater than, make a space, give it a little bit of, so it looks readable, A with the index of J plus 1, so it's going to look at A of J, whatever index that is, if the first iteration is going to be 0, and then it's going to look at A index 1, and if that's greater than this, we need to swap those two numbers. Okay, so you can't just say A J equals AJ plus 1 and AJ plus 1 equals AJ because you're going to overwrite something and lose it. So what we need to do is throw AJ plus 1 into a temporary value. So let's create a temp int temp equals AJ plus 1 index, and then we are going to set AJ plus 1 set that equal to A index J. Alright, this sounds very confusing. This is what you're going to see when you read it out of a book, and when I run through it up here for you, it'll make a little bit more sense, hopefully. So now we're going to set A index J equal to temp. Alright, so that is our method, and we do need to return A afterwards. So return A, and let's also just make a printout method down here. So public static void print array, we'll pass in another array variable, call it A again, and this will just be one for loop, and we'll say for int I equals 0, and we can say I is less than A dot length, and I plus plus. This shouldn't be anything new. This is just a for loop printing out each element of the array. So we're going to say, sys o. And Eclipse, a shortcut, you can say sys out or sys o, and then control space, and it'll automatically do system.out.println. So that's a good shortcut, so you don't have to write that all the time. That's what I do now. So let's say A index whatever iteration it's on. Alright, and now just to show you that it works, we can say bubble sort, and we can pass in numbers to its argument. And then we can say print array, and also put in numbers. So right now, if I said print array, it would print out 10, 5, 3, 7, 2. After I do bubble sort, it should print out 2, 3, 5, 7, 10. So let's see what the outcome is. There we go, 2, 3, 5, 7, 10. So you know that this works. Now let me show you what happens. All right, for the first iteration, we are going to start A, or not A, I at 0 index. Okay, so this first row is your index of the array. These are your elements of the array. This is the I variable, the J variable, and then this is going to keep track of the sorted part of the array. We don't need that right now. We will, though. So right now, when we start it up, everything is at I, or 0. So I is at 0, J is at 0. And we're going to check if the array at index J, which is 10, is greater than the element at array index j plus 1. So it's saying, is this bigger than this? And yes, it is. So what we do now is we say, you're going to set this temp variable to a j plus 1. So we're going to put in that 5, because j plus 1 is this first index. We'll put a 5 there. And we get rid of that when we do our next step, and it's going to say, so now j plus 1, set that equal to what a of j is. So we're going to put that 10 right there. So if we just stopped it there, we have two 10s. So now we need to set a of j, which at this time is 0, to this temp. So now we can throw that 5 right here. All right, and since we did that, we can increment j to 1. So let's get rid of that, and we'll put j right there. And yeah, this is going to not be very pretty, but now what we're going to do is we're going to say, is j greater than j plus 1? And yes, it is. So we are going to set this temp from equal to j plus 1, so that would be a 3. Then we would set this to a 10, and then we would set a of j to a 3. Alright, and now we would just increment j here, and we would do the same test, and yes, this is bigger than 7, and we would throw the 7 into the temp variable, and make that a 10, and this would be a 7. And increment j. Okay, so now j is at index 3. So right here, j equals 3, and we're going to run that while it is less than the array.length, which is 5, minus 1, which is 4. So we can't increment j to here, so it's only going to go to there. That's why we're going to end up having this I variable. Now that it's at the second to last index, it's going to check that one and j plus 1. And it's going to switch that again. So that 2 is going to go into the temp. The 10 is going to go where that 2 was. And then we're going to put the temp back into where that 10 was. Okay? And now we can set this pointer right here. I'll just have it as an x. And that's going to show you where the array has been sorted. So this part right now is the sorted array. and j goes back to 0, and I now goes to 1. Okay, and then j is going to go all the way to 2 this time instead of 3, because we have this while j is less than array.length, which is 5, minus 1, which is 4, minus I, which is 1 at the time, and that will make it to where it will only go to 2. It'll only check index 2 versus index 3, because we know that index 4 is sorted. And it's called a bubble sort because each time we go through this, the biggest number in the unsorted part of the array bubbles to the top right here. And every iteration through this array, it's going to keep doing that until we only have index 0, which should be the smallest number. So that is the logic behind the bubble sort algorithm. I hope that made a little bit of sense to you. It's not the funnest thing to describe when you're describing these letters and the indexes of the array, but it works, and this should be a good intro to sorting for you. And if you like, please subscribe below. I will try to keep making these sorting videos, starting with the easiest and going into the harder, more efficient ones. So thank you guys for watching.